This video will show you how to install CrossOver Linux on your Linux machine. Now it's important to note that there are many, many different Linux distributions. The default package management system or install software tool will vary quite a bit depending on the type of Linux that you're using. So as a general rule, you should attempt to install CrossOver from the appropriate package, that's a .deb or .rpm file, using the default installer program on your system. This means that in most cases, all you need to do is download the CrossOver installer package, again, .rpm or .deb, and double-click on it. Every once in a while, we do find particular installer programs that don't work properly with CrossOver. Sometimes it's our fault, sometimes it's theirs. As always, if you're stuck, ask us at info@codeweavers.com or check out the tutorials section on our website where we have written instructions for all of this. So this video is going to show you how to install from the .bin file, which is a shell script. Again, we do recommend that you use the .rpm or .deb package if possible, but if your distribution does not support either of those packages or you just really want to use the .bin, here's how. So you're first going to download it from our trial page and save the file. Don't double click on the .bin to open it. Most systems will try to open it in a text editor, and that is not what you want. You want to open up a terminal and then run the .bin in the terminal. Here we're just dropping in the terminal via drag and drop. If you're handy with terminal, there's other ways of doing it, but this is perhaps the easiest. Press enter to run it. You're gonna get a permission denied error the first time you run it. That's perfectly fine. Just enter chmod755 like you see here, run the file again, press enter, and then run the file again without the chmod and press enter, and that is going to correct the permissions and launch the installer. So here's the installer running. You're gonna approve the license. Install into the default, which is going to be in your home directory. If you want to install for all users, you put it in /opt, but for simplicity's sake, we're just going to install into the user's home directory here. CrossOver is going to report that it's finishing the installation. Click finish, and CrossOver is going to spit out some errors in the terminal here. You can ignore those, they don't mean anything. Click Always Update when the software installer launches for the first time. You always want to be up to date with the software installer so you've got the latest install packages, and you are good to go. Now for our example here, we're using a Fedora 16 system with the GNOME 3 desktop environment. So to launch CrossOver, we'll go to our Applications menu, and then you will see over on the right hand side there's a CrossOver section where you've got install software, manage bottles, and all of the other fun things that make CrossOver go.